scathing review into three medical treatments for women in England says that many lives have been ruined because of an arrogant culture that dismissed serious concerns as women's problems. Well, let's talk more about that, because this report out today from Baroness Julia Cumberlege suggested there were so many failings when it came to one particular medical device, mesh, and two types of drugs, and that officials didn't listen to the concerns of those women. There are a number of recommendations from Baroness Julia Cumberlege. We'll get reaction now from Kate Langley, who had a mesh implant for incontinence back in 2012. Kate, hello to you. Good morning.
Hi.
Now, you were one of the first women I interviewed when when our programme started to report several years ago on mesh implants. How do you feel now you have read this report?
Well, I'm obviously really, really happy. I'm so pleased. I think after all the campaigning that all of us women have done for so many years, that it's finally paid off. And it's amazing that that we've been heard, basically. Our voices have been heard. And to receive an apology earlier this morning from Matt Hancock, that was such an emotional moment for me to hear that. It was amazing.
Remind us what impact having mesh fitted in you back in 2012 has had on you.
Oh, I don't know where to start. A massive impact into my life. It caused me to have multiple admissions, over 50 admissions to hospital. Many were agonising admissions where I would receive sort of childbirth-like contraction pain. I would collapse on the floor, I'd need an ambulance, I'd need morphine, gas and air. And then to sort of go into hospital and for them to not know what is wrong with you, to be dismissed, and for the pain to always be blamed on something else other than the mesh. It was such hard to deal with. And then trying to get the treatment that you need, years of sort of going from one doctor to another. But I've had like four removal surgeries now, and thank goodness my last removal surgery, I hope that they actually finally remove the last piece. But you know, each surgery is a major operation, and it takes an awful lot of recovery, and you're never quite the same afterwards because you're left with lots and lots of pain. I now suffer with fibromyalgia, so I have good and bad days, but bad days are really not good. So it's you know, it has a lasting effect on your life.
And before you got to the point of trying to get the mesh out of you, I think medics thought it might be gallstones, so you had those removed. Yeah. Then you had a full hysterectomy because they thought it might be that.
Yeah.
And it wasn't that.
No. Every time it was almost like they were clutching at straws to try and find what was wrong with me. And each time they said they're not entirely convinced that this was the cause of my pain, but they would try these operations to see if the pains would stop. But I think the problem was that the mesh doesn't show up on lots of scans, MRI scans, ultrasounds, so you can't tell that it's cutting into your tissues. You can't tell that it's you know, sort of slicing through organs. It's not until you actually do a surgical procedure that you actually can tell that it's the mesh that's causing all these problems. So in the meantime, I had those operations because I was desperate, and I just went along with what the medics were recommending because I just was so desperate to be well again.
Yeah, of course. And whenever we've talked about this subject, whether it's pelvic mesh, vaginal mesh, or hernia mesh, we started to get emails particularly from men about they'd had mesh for hernias. I just get so many messages. Alison says, on your programme this morning, you've covered a feature on vaginal mesh. I had this fitted many years ago, and I've subsequently suffered with extreme pain. I'm now going to contact my GP to investigate what I should do, but will be grateful for any information as to who I can contact for further advice. I look forward to hearing from you. Well, I mean, for a start, Alison could go to the Sling the Mesh Facebook page. Kate, would you recommend that?
Yeah. I totally would recommend that. There's so many other women that are suffering like we all have done, and we've all been through this journey, so we can all offer support as to where they should go to try and get the help and in which order and how to go about obtaining that help, I would highly recommend Sling the Mesh. Cass Sampson's been obviously brilliant setting up the page in the first place, and we've sort of gone from 30 people right up to over 8,000 women now. And I think just as much as it's totally heartbreaking to know that there's that many women that are also suffering and men, it's also kind of good to know you're not alone and it's not in your head, and that there are people out there for you.
And that's a good point about not feeling alone, because Julie emails to say, my mum was subjected to a mesh repair to her abdomen following bowel cancer surgery. It would not heal, and she noticed a small protrusion from the wound. The nurse investigated with tweezers and found it was the corner of mesh sticking out from the wound. She pulled the mesh completely out of my mother's abdomen with the tweezers. The pain was excruciating, and to date she still complains of pain in her abdomen almost 10 years later. I have been unaware of this problem until seeing your show this morning, so thank you for bringing it to our attention. So it's still happening, Kate.
That's amazing. That's amazing. It's so good to know that women are finding out, and because of your show and the Victoria Derbyshire show over the years, I think, you know, we've reached thousands of women, so it is an amazing thing. I'm so grateful to you as well for all of the work that you've done for us to highlight this, this awful situation that we've all found ourselves in. You know, we can't thank you enough, Victoria, that you've been amazing.
Well, that's really kind of you, and that is why we're here. Can I talk to you about the recommendations from Baroness Cumberlege? Because she hasn't recommended that mesh be banned, but she's put in so many conditions before the pause can be lifted. Then Kath Sampson said to us earlier it's effectively a ban by the back door. But things like a patient safety commissioner, somebody completely independent of all the regulatory bodies, all the clinicians, independent of the government, who could be an advocate for people like yourself, specialist mesh centres to help with the removal of it, and redress and support for all those who've been affected.
Yeah, they're all brilliant things. And I don't think we ever imagined that it would be completely banned. But I think now it's almost going to be very hard for women to go and have it without being fully counselled and fully knowing all of the problems, and then having these things in place will help them should things go wrong in the future. Mm-hmm. and for all medical devices, which is, you know, another amazing thing too.
Yeah. Well, Kate, listen, thank you so much for talking to us again. You've had a lot of challenges. I know there are more challenges ahead, so I want to wish you all the best. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you so much for everything, Victoria. We really, really appreciate it. Thank you.
Okay. Take care. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, the investigation headed by Baroness Cumberlege focused on two other scandals as well as pelvic mesh: the hormone pregnancy test Primados and an anti-epilepsy drug called sodium valproate. Anna Collinson has this.
Daniel Mason has to work far harder to do the simplest of tasks. He was born